You mentioned on the phone about double stop or chords in that.
Well, when
in
you,
that video I posted.
Yeah, in the video you were putting in some extra chords that I'm basically the three chords, right? I'm not. I can do sevenths and I can do minors, but I thought you were throwing in some passing chords there that were. I think it was in. Was it Big Mon? I think it was Big Mon.
Sorry. Old strings. Need to change them before tonight. So, chords that I was playing in there. I don't... I'm trying to think about what you mean by the chords I was playing in there. I was totally improvising on that.
Oh, yeah?
So I'm trying to, I don't know. You mean rhythmically, like.
You just threw in some stuff that I didn't recognize. Up here. Like, you threw in some chords up there that were innate that I didn't. Like, I know this one. But I just thought there was a couple there that I didn't see before, but that's okay.
I can't imagine. I would have to watch that video to see again what I did because I
was
just improvising.
Well, the other thing I got is my set list. Maybe just get breaks for them.
All right.
First one I do is Soul Down the River. It's a Dan Paisley one that I liked. It goes, where is the love that you promised in the pine? Gone like the flowers in the fall. You crossed your heart, now you're double crossing mine. You've been pretending after all. I was soul down the river, the water broke in the green. Drifting sorrow down the stream. Soul down the river, the water broke in the green.
Lots
there.
What's that?
Oh,
it's like that Scotty Stoneman. You ever listen to Scotty Stoneman at all?
No.
Fiddle player, but he was a hell of a mandolin player too. But
yeah?
Mainly a fiddle. anyway, that so it's doing... just kind of a crazy double stop thing, right? So.
Oh, you're doing an open.
But don't slide it. Oh, slide it, but pick it too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, up down though. You know.
All right.
Where you have that melody that, you know, starts out on that the fifth note, you know, you could play that like syncopated and odd.
Those hammer-ons.
I'm trying to figure out how I play it with the pick. Yeah. So it's it's basically that.
But you're doing a pull-off too. Yeah.
It's like that, right? In G, that's it. It's that old Monroe thing, like that whole thing, or that idea. You can do it in A or B, or anywhere you start on that seventh note, you know. So you're hitting this note with a pick and then this one with a pick, but all the rest of it is. Yeah, and you can play it, you know, you can do it slow as you need it. So it'd be like, we play the open with the pick, though. Ah. Shit. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah, that's neat. That's neat. Work or not. Okay, the next one's almost the same.
So
sorry, I'm trying to get that lick in there.
Yeah, you did it. Yeah. Cool. Cool. I can use that. Yeah.
It's kind of a handy little one.
Yeah.
Bastardized Monroe lick.
Okay, I'm gonna try one in B now. Stuff like but my little finger's lazy.
That's that's a common mandolinist trait is having that finger be lazy. But it's basically this same G position here, only moved up to B.
Yeah.
You know, that's the Bill Monroe talked about playing out of shapes, and he did it a lot, you know, like that. Yeah, and kind of the big thing about it is it's an arpeggio, right? This you can do it in a lot of different places, but. Use these three fingers here, Mike.
These three?
These three.
your third finger and put it on the eighth fret of the G string.
Your third finger?
Yep. Put that on the G string now. One down. There you go. And then play those three. Yeah. So you can... And then you're right here at E. Then you make it 9, 6, 7. But check out my fingers here. And then you're in the same position. Then you can play that same, so you start with that. It's basically just getting, playing up in, you end up in this position in B, this thing, which is no different than if you're playing. I was trying to think of how, that tune, Katie Hill, you ever heard of that?
No, I've heard about it, but I don't play it yet.
Well, this G right here. Think of all these positions as G, right? As the positions you can get out of G. Start with G. And you've got this, you've got this position, you've got this.
Okay, I don't know that one.
Yeah, it's... This would be a good exercise for learning where these scales are at, because right here, there's a G major scale right here.
Oh, yeah, I know about that one. Yeah, I use that one.
Okay, so if you're gonna go to B, this is why it's important to learn the fingerboard. If you go to this B, then you've got this B major scale right here.
Where is that?
In this position, which would be G right here, right?
I've never used that one.
Yeah, if you check this example out in G, here's your G major scale starting out of this position. Starting on B. Just go up the scale. But let's stay in this position here. So here in B, the only thing you do is you close it up, right? If you were to play that close, it'd be this. This is where getting that pinky in there is really going to help you for playing in those upper positions, right?
That's not a G there, is it?
That's a B.
B, okay.
Yep, starts on a B note.
Okay.
But I mean, you could start the scale on that. You know, it doesn't. It's the major third, right? It makes the G chord a G chord. That right there.
Yeah.
So you can start.
Okay, that's a G scale starting on B.
Mm-hmm.
You're using that in the key of B?
No.
No. Okay.
I'm using this as an example to show you that it's not such a mysterious thing, right? If you play that close. Instead of playing those open strings, then you can play that scale. This is the B one.
Oh, all right.
I'm telling you, that scale pattern.
Where was it again? Starting on the B?
But play instead of playing those open strings, play them closed.
Well, what do I? I'm hitting an open string there.
Yeah, play with your pinky. Play the 7th
oh.
fret.
Oh, and that's what I'm doing wrong.
Now I'm gonna play all the other ones closed too. Yeah, but play that open E on the 7th too.
Little finger busy now.
Yeah, well, I mean, this'll, you know, working on it will really open up all kinds of different worlds. So if you move that up a half step, you've got an A flat major scale, yeah. Right? 2 frets is A, again is, you know, but it's that same pattern. That pattern doesn't change. Sorry. So in B, it's... And then you've got that, you're in that shape, right?
Yeah.
And then
you...
And that makes it 7, right? Flatting that 7th note. And you're, and then here you're in. You think of this when you go to the E chord. You can think of that. It's the same thing. You take that same pattern.
What's that next note? Oh.
Again, pinky. Right, but you're if you're playing out of that B or A or anything G, you know, Blue Night and G would be like, patterns change if you're going up the scale or if you're in G. It's the same. Right? And then if your 4 chord is there. 1 chord. And then your 5 chord is here. Like your D down here, right?
Yeah.
So that's, yeah. When you close this stuff up, it makes it a lot easier to, you know, but it means...
Using that.
Yeah, it means really getting to work on that. Yeah. And if you watch Bill Monroe, he used it a lot more than a lot of people who are his followers, you know? Yeah. It's not like, you watch Chris Thiele or Mike Marshall or something, they're using that constantly all the time. But,
yeah.
You know, Bill did it too. And people have taken the lazy approach to it and tried not to use it. And I did so for years too.
Well, that's me.
I avoided using my pinky because it's hard. It's hard to get that. And it's not as fast as my other 3.
Yeah.
You know, but if you put some time into using it, it opens up so many more, and it's easier in the long run to play than it is to play. And it just, you know. It's just that bluesy thing that could be. Take in. That's why I said bring a tape recorder or video or something, you know, because
I'm gonna turn this off now.
No, that's